Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan. I am happy to meet you through this video lecture series on the subject heat and mass transfer. And this is module number 4, lectures on heat exchanger, lecture number 2. And the topic for the lecture number 2 is problems on LMTD method. So we recap from the previous lecture. So in the previous lecture, we defined the heat exchanger and we classified the heat exchanger. We have seen different types of heat exchanger and we discussed the LMTD method for the heat exchanger design. And we are doing only thermal design. Calculating the temperatures of the heat transfer fluid, calculating the heat transfer rate, and calculating the area. And in this lecture, we are going to solve few problems on the LMTD method. And after listening to this video, the student, you will be able to solve problems on the LMTD method on your own. And I would like to give some clarification on overall heat transfer coefficient before we take up the problem. We define the overall heat transfer coefficient based on the inside area and outside area. There are three resistances involved, ignoring the effect of the folding. The resistance due to the inside heat transfer, convection heat transfer, and resistance due to the conduction, and resistance due to the outside convection heat transfer. And here also you find the internal convection, the conduction between the surface inlet and the inside and the outside surface, and the outside convection. We assume this condition. To simplify this equation, we assume this condition. Ri equal to Ro. That means the thickness of the tube wall is very, very minimum. That is also true. We take the heat exchanger tubes are few centimeter in diameter. So the obviously the thickness of the tube is negligible comparing with the diameter and length of the heat exchanger pipe. So ignoring the thickness, considering Ri equal to approximately equal to Ro. And here in the first term, this Ri equal to Ro, that is getting cancelled, equal to 1. Ri, Ro equal logarithmic 1 equal to 0. The middle term becomes 0. And finally, what is left out? Ui equal to 1 by Hi plus 1 by HO. Similarly, here in the UO, once again, middle term becomes 0. And here Ro equal to Ra getting cancelled, equal to 1. I will get the 1 by Hi plus 1 by HO. So if you look at the two equations are identical. So when the inside, the conduction resistance is ignored, the condition is thickness of the wall is very minimum, Ri equal to Ro. So when the conduction is negligible comparing with the inside convection and the inside outside convection, and the overall heat transfer coefficient 1 by U equal to 1 by Hi plus 1 by HO. So where Hi is the inside heat transfer coefficient and HO is the outside heat transfer coefficient. Knowing the two values, you can calculate. If suppose the value U is not given directly, you will be given Hi and HO values. From that, you can calculate the overall heat transfer coefficient. So we take the first example. Example 1, the flow rate of hot and the cold water streams running through a parallel flow heat exchanger are 0.2 kilograms per second and 0.5 kilograms per second respectively. The inlet temperature of the hot and the cold side are 75 degrees Celsius and 25 degrees Celsius. The exit temperature of the hot water is 45 degrees Celsius. The individual heat transfer coefficient on both sides are 650 watts per meter square Kelvin. Calculate the area of the heat exchanger. So after reading the problem, you write down the given data. So given data in this problem, mass of the hot fluid 0.2 kilograms per second, mass of the cold fluid 0.5 kilograms per second, inlet temperature of the hot fluid 75 degrees Celsius, outlet temperature of the hot fluid 45 degrees Celsius, inlet temperature of the cold fluid 25 degrees Celsius, HA equal to HO equal to 650 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the specific heat. So here the specific heat of the hot and the cold fluids are given. The hot fluid inlet and the outlet temperatures are given. So you calculate the specific heat. You take the specific heat from the mean temperature. So the mean temperature of the hot fluid, THA plus THO divided by 2 equal to 60 degrees Celsius. From the heat and mass transfer data book, the property, the specific heat of water at this temperature, it is 4183 joules per kilogram Kelvin. For cold fluid, the inlet temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. You take the CPC, specific heat of the cold water, as 4178 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And we know heat loss by the hot water is equal to heat gained by the cold water. That is the basic principle for heat exchanger design. So, substituting the left hand side and right hand side. So, the heat loss by the hot fluid MH, CPH, THA minus THO, it is equal to heat gained by the cold water MC, CPC into TCO minus TCI. Substituting all the value, the net heat transfer equal to 25098 equal to 2089 into TCO minus TCI. Solving this equation, the outlet temperature of the cold water is 37 degree Celsius. Now, we have to calculate the LMTD for parallel flow heat exchanger. So, this is the equation. LMTD equal to THI minus TCI minus THO minus TCO divided by logarithmic of THI minus TCI divided by THO minus TCO. And in your data book, heat and mass transfer data book, this is the equation given. I told you already, capital T stands for hot fluid, small t stands for cold fluid, 1 stands for inlet and 2 stands for outlet. So, THA equal to capital T1, TCI equal to small t1, THO equal to capital T2, TCO equal to small t2 and logarithmic of this value. The same thing again as in the numerator. Now, substituting the numerical values, 75 minus 25 minus 45 minus 37, that is divided by logarithmic of 50 divided by 8, which is 22.92 degree Celsius. And the overall heat transfer coefficient, so you are given 1 by E equal to 1 by HA plus 1 by HO equal to 1 by 650 plus 1 by 650 equal to 1 by 325. So U equal to 325 watts per meter square Kelvin. And the heat transfer area required, that is the question that you have to calculate, A equal to Q by U into LMTD. So, substituting Q value, U and LMTD, the area of the heat exchanger is 26.45 meters square. So, that is what you have to calculate, area of the heat exchanger. So, that is the, so you calculate, what is, look at the procedure. You take this equation, heat loss by the hot fluid equal to heat gained by the cold fluid, and calculate the outlet temperature, calculate the LMTD, calculate the U, and you take this equation and substitute, find out what is area required for heat transfer. And we take the example number 2. In a counterflow double pipe heat exchanger, water is heated from 25 degrees Celsius to 60 degrees Celsius by oil with a specific heat of 1450 joules per kilogram Kelvin and the mass flow rate 0.9 kilograms per second. The oil is cooled from 230 degrees Celsius to 160 degrees Celsius. The overall heat transfer coefficient U is 420 watts per meter square Kelvin. Calculate the rate of heat transfer, mass flow rate of water and the surface area of the heat exchange. And this is asked in the Anna University examination in May 2004 and November 2006. And write down the given data, read the problem carefully again and write down the given data. So, the mass of the hot oil is 0.9 kilograms per second. Specific heat of the oil is 1450 joules per kilogram Kelvin. Temperature at the inlet of the oil 230 degrees Celsius. Outlet temperature of the oil is 160 degrees Celsius. Cold water inlet temperature 25 degrees Celsius. Outlet temperature 60 degrees Celsius. And the U is 420 watts per meter square Kelvin. and the heat transfer rate, that is heat loss by the oil or heat gain by the water, Q equal to MHCPH into THI minus THO, which is 0.9 into 1450 multiplied by 230 minus 160 equal to 91,350 watts. That is what the heat transfer rate. And for water, the specific heat we have to calculate. So again, the two temperatures are given, water inlet temperature, water outlet temperatures are given. So you take the mean temperature, which is 42.5 degrees Celsius. So at this mean temperature, you calculate, you find out the specific heat of water from the data book, which is 4178.625 joules per kilogram Kelvin. Now the mass flow rate of the water, MC equal to Q divided by CPC into TCO minus TCI, substituting 91,350 divided by 4178.625 into 60 minus 25 equal to 0.625 kilograms per second. Then the LMTD for the counter flow heat exchanger. THI minus TCO, LMTD equal to THI minus TCO minus THO minus TCI divided by logarithmic of THI minus TCO divided by THO minus TCI. So in terms of the number, in terms of the data given in your equation given in your data book, this is THI equal to capital T1, TCO equal to small t2, THO equal to capital T2, TCI equal to small t1, and logarithmic of capital T1 minus small t2 divided by capital T2 minus small t1. Substituting in terms of numerical values, 230 minus 60 minus 160 minus 25 divided by logarithmic of 170 divided by 135, which is 151.83 degrees Celsius. Then the area required, A equal to Q divided by U into LMTD for counter flow heat exchanger, which is 91,350 divided by U value is 420 and LMTD is 151.83. So the area required is 1.43 meter square. So this is for counter flow heat exchanger. Now next problem we take, it is desired to use a cylinder tube heat exchanger to heat 68 kilograms per minute of water from 35 degrees Celsius to 75 degrees Celsius by using oil having specific heat of 1900 joules per kilogram Kelvin. The oil enters at a temperature of 1100 degrees Celsius and flows at a rate of 170 kilograms per minute. The water makes shell pass and oil makes the tube passes. Calculate the area required for a heat exchanger assuming overall heat transfer coefficient to be 300 watts per meter square Kelvin and specific heat of water to be 4.18 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And given data here, mass of the hot water 170 kilograms per minute, which is 2.83 kilograms per second, specific heat of the oil, which is 1900 joules per kilogram Kelvin, and hot oil inlet temperature 100 degrees Celsius, and water inlet temperature 35 degrees Celsius, water outlet temperature 75 degrees Celsius, mass of the water is 68 kilograms per minute, which is 1.13 kilograms per second. The overall heat transfer coefficient is 300 watts per meter square Kelvin, and specific heat of water is 4180 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And calculating the heat transfer rate, the heat gained by the water, Q equal to MCPC into TCO minus TCI, substituting 1.13 into 4180 into 71 minus 35, which is 188,936 watts. The amount of heat transfer equal to 188,936 watts. The exit temperature of the oil, THO equal to THI minus Q divided by MH and CPH, which is equal to 110 minus 188,936 divided by 2.83 into 1900, which is 75 degrees Celsius. And the LMTD for counter flow heat exchanger, so you refer to the previous equation, THI minus TCO minus THO minus TCI divided by logarithmic of THI minus TCO divided by THO minus TCI, substituting numerical values, LMTD equal to 37.4 degrees Celsius. So the equation repeatedly we are using, so you have to remember, so that is better, you remember the equation so that fluently you can write the LMTD dedication for counter flow and parallel flow heat exchanger. And now this is a shell-end tube heat exchanger. Now we have to calculate the P and the R value. So P value TCO minus TCI divided by THI minus TCI. What is given in your data book is TCO equal to small t2, TCI equal to small t1, THI equal to capital T1 and TCI equal to small t1. Substituting numerical values, P equal to 0.53 and R equal to THI minus THO divided by TCO minus TCI. That is temperature difference of the hot fluid divided by temperature difference of the cold fluid. Substituting numerical value 110 minus 75 divided by 75 minus 35, which is 0.875. Now the correction factor for shell and tube heat exchanger from page number 159, for the calculated value of P and P equal to 0.53 and R equal to 0.875, the F value correction factor F equal to 0.79. Now the area required for the heat exchanger, A equal to Q divided by U into F into LMTD, which is 188936 divided by 300 into 0.79 into 37.4, which is 21.31 meter square. That is what the area of the heat exchanger. And we take the example number 4, a single shell pass, 4 tube pass heat exchanger is used to cool lubricating oil from 70 degrees Celsius to 45 degrees Celsius at a rate of 15 kilograms per second. The water is at 25 degrees Celsius used at a flow rate of 15 kilograms per second. Determine the area required if the overall heat transfer coefficient has a value of 150 watts per meter square Kelvin. The oil has a specific heat of 2.3 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So this is in the anagnostic examination November 2007. So read the problem and write down the given data. We are given mass of the hot fluid, hot oil is 15 kilograms per second. Specific heat of the oil is 2300 joules per kilogram Kelvin. Inlet temperature of the oil is 70 degrees Celsius. Outlet temperature of the oil 45 degrees Celsius. Inlet temperature of the water is 25 degrees Celsius. MC, mass of the water, is 15 kilograms per second. Overall heat transfer coefficient is 150 and the specific heat of the water is 4178 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And the heat loss by the lubricating oil, that is what the heat transfer. So heat transfer equal to M into CPH into THO minus THI, which is 15 into 2300 into 70 minus 45, which is 8,62,500 watts. Then the exit temperature of the water, TCO equal to TCI plus Q divided by MCPC, which is equal to 25 plus 862,500 divided by 15 into 4178, which is 38.8 degree Celsius. And the LMTD for counter flow heat exchanger, substituting the value, numerical value is 70 minus 38.8 minus 45 minus 25 divided by logarithmic of 31.2 divided by logarithmic 20, which is 25.2 degree Celsius. Now this is again shell and tube heat exchanger. You have to find out the P and R value. So P equal to TCO minus TCI divided by THI minus TCI, which is 38.8 minus 25 divided by 70 minus 25, which is 0.31. And R value equal to THI minus THO divided by TCO minus TCI, which is 70 minus 45 divided by 38.8 minus 25 equal to 1.81. So the data from the page number 160 for one shell and four tube passes, P equal to 0.31 and R equal to 1.81, so F equal to 0.89. So this is from the data. And once you have the value, you can calculate the area required for the heat exchanger. So A equal to Q divided by U into F into LMTD, which is 862,500 divided by 150 into 0.89 in 25.2, which is 256.37 meter square. And the problem number 5, example number 5, calculate the following cases. The surface area required for a heat exchanger, which is required to cool 3200 kilograms per hour of benzene of specific heat 1.74 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin from 72 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. the cooling water with a specific heat of 4.18 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin at 15 degrees Celsius has a flow rate of 2200 kilograms per hour. So the first case, single pass counter flow heat exchanger. Second case, one shell, four tube pass heat exchanger. And third case, cross flow single pass with the water mixed benzene unmixed heat exchanger. Assume all the cases, you take U equal to 0.28 kilowatts per meter square Kelvin. And reading the problem and write down the given data. So data given here, mass of the hot water is 3200 kilograms per hour, which is 0.89 kilograms per second. Specific heat of the oil, it is 1740 joules per kilogram Kelvin, and the hot water inlet temperature is 72 degrees Celsius. Hot oil outlet temperature is 42 degrees Celsius. Cold water temperature is 15 degrees Celsius. Mass of the cold water is 2200 kilograms per hour, which is 0.61 kilograms per second. Overall heat transfer coefficient is 280 watts per meter square Kelvin, and specific heat of the water is 4180 joules per kilogram. And the heat transfer rate, which is the equal to heat loss by the benzene, the hot fluid, which is Q equal to MH CpH into THi minus THO, which is 0.89 into 1740 into 72 minus 42, which is 46,458 watts. And exit temperature of the water, so TCO equal to TCI plus Q divided by M into CPC, which is 15 plus 4648 divided by 0.16 into 4180, which is 33.2 degree Celsius. And the LMTD for the counterflow heat exchanger, LMTD equal to THi minus TCO minus THO minus TCI divided by logarithmic of THi minus TCO divided by THO minus TCI. Substituting the numeric value, the LMTD for the counterflow configuration is 32.5 degree Celsius. So you carefully listen to the equation and substitute the numerical value and calculate the LMTD. Practice the problem, that is very important. So you just listen to the video and practice the problem. And for all the three cases here, we require the correction factor. So P equal to TCO minus TCI divided by THi minus TCI, which is 0.32. R equal to THi minus THO divided by TCO minus TCI, which is 1.65. Now, area required for single pass counter flow, A equal to Q divided by U into LMTD, which is 46,458 divided by 280 into 32.5, which is 5.1 meter square. So, one shell, four tube pass heat exchanger, and the correction factor from page number 159, which is 0.89. So, P equal to 0.32, R equal to 1.65. FL equal to 0.89, and this area required equal to Q divided by U into F into LMTD. So 46,458 divided by 280 into 0.89 into 32.5, which is 5.74 meters square. And the cross flow heat exchanger with the benzene unmixed water mixed, the correction factor from page number 161. For water mixed and the benzene unmixed, P equal to 0.32, R equal to 1.65, F equal to 0.80. So, calculating the area equal to Q divided by U into F into LMTD, 46,458 divided by 280 into 0.88 into 32.5, which is 5.8 meters square. So, the three cases we have calculated the area. Then the example number 6. Water is evaporated continuously at 100 degrees Celsius in an evaporator by cooling 500 kilograms per hour of air from 260 degrees Celsius to 150 degrees Celsius. Calculate the heat transfer area required and the steam evaporation rate per hour if the liquid enters at 100 degrees Celsius. U equal to 46 watts per meter square Kelvin and Cp specific heat of air equal to 1005 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And write down the given data. This is evaporator boiler. So, evaporating the water with the help of the hot gases. So, specific heat of the hot gas is 1005 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And hot gases inlet temperature is 260 degrees Celsius. outlet temperature is 150 degrees Celsius. The cold fluid is water, which is entering as a water and leaving as a steam. So THI equal to TCO equal to 100 degree Celsius. Mass of the hot gases are 500 kilograms per kilogram per second. Kilograms per hour, that is equal to 0.14 kilograms per second, and U equal to 46 watts per meter square Kelvin. So the heat loss by the hot air, MHCPH into THI minus THO, which is 0.14 into 1005 into 260 minus 150 equal to 154.77 watts. And the LMTD for the counterflow configuration, so THI minus TCO divided minus THO minus TCI divided by logarithmic of THI minus TCO divided by THO minus TCI, substituting the numerical values, the LMTD for counterflow configuration, it is 94.57 degree Celsius. Now the area required for the evaporator for counterflow configuration, so A equal to Q divided by U into LMTD, which is 15,477 divided by U equal to 46, and LMTD is 94.57. The area required is equal to 3.56 meter square. So this is the evaporator problem, and latent heat of evaporation of water is HFG equal to 2256.9 kilojoules per kilogram. And this value from the steam table at the temperature 100 degree Celsius. Now mass of the water evaporated, M equal to Q divided by HFG. So heat transfer is 15,477 joules, that is watts per joules per second, divided by the value 2256.9 into 1000. This gives in kilograms per second. We want kilograms per hour, multiplying by 3600. So this is going to be 24.69 kilograms per hour. So the mass of the water evaporated into steam, which is 24.69 kilograms per hour. And we take another example in the condenser. Example number 7, a steam condenses at the atmospheric pressure on external surface of the tube of a steam condenser. Diameter of each tube is 30 millimeter, length is 10 meter. Inlet and the outlet temperature of the cooling water flowing inside the tube is 25 degrees Celsius and 60 degrees Celsius respectively. If the flow rate is 1.1 kilograms per second and the U equal to overall heat transfer coefficient, U equal to 250 watts per meter square Kelvin, calculate the rate of condensation and number of tubes required. And read the problem, write down the given data. So diameter of the tube is 0.03 meter, length equal to 10 meter, cold water inlet temperature 25 degrees Celsius, cold water outlet temperature is 60 degrees Celsius, and the mass of the water is 1.1 kilograms per second. Overall heat transfer coefficient U equal to 250 watts per meter square Kelvin. The hot water inlet and the hot steam inlet temperature and outlet temperatures are equal 100 degrees Celsius. This is the saturation temperature at atmospheric pressure. The steam condenses at atmospheric pressure. So at atmospheric pressure, the temperature, saturation temperature is 100 degree Celsius. And the specific heat of water at the mean temperature. So the value is not given. You have to take it from the data book, heat and mass transfer data book. So for the mean temperature of the water, which is 42.5 degree Celsius, the CPC specific heat of water is 4178.6 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And the heat gained by the cooling water, Q equal to MC CPC into TCO minus TCI, which is 1.1 into 4187.6 into 60 minus 25, which is 160,878.1 watts. The amount of heat gained by the water is 160,876.1 watts. And latent heat of condensation at 100 degrees Celsius, which is 2256.9 kilojoules per kilogram, is again from the steam table at 100 degrees Celsius. Latent heat of evaporation, which is latent heat of condensation. Mass of condensate formed, M equal to Q divided by HFG, which is 168.76.1 divided by 2256.9 into 1000 into 3600 to get the value in kilograms per hour, which is 256.6 kilograms per hour. This is what the condensate formed in the condenser. And LMTD for the counterflow configuration. So THI minus TCO minus THO minus TCA divided by logarithmic of THI minus TCO divided by THO minus TCA, substituting the numerical value, that is equal to 55.68 degree Celsius. Now the area required for the counterflow arrangement in the condenser, A equal to Q divided by U into LMTD, which is 160876.1 divided by 250 is overall heat transfer coefficient into 55.68 equal to 11.56 meters square. This is what the area required for the condenser. And number of tubes required. So from the area equal to pi dl, total area of the heat exchanger equal to area of the pipe into number of pipes. So area of the pipe equal to surface area of the pipe equal to pi dl. So number of tubes required, n equal to a divided by area divided by pi into d into l. So 11.56 divided by pi into diameter equal to 0.03 meter and length equal to 10 meter, that is equal to 13. So 13 numbers of tubes are required for this condenser. And example number 8, an automotive radiator may be viewed as a cross flow heat exchanger with both fluid and mixed. Water with a flow rate of 0.05 kilograms per second enters at 400 Kelvin, leaves at 330 Kelvin. The water is cooled by air which enters at 300 Kelvin with a flow rate of 0.75 kilograms per second. The overall heat transfer coefficient is 200 watts per meter square Kelvin. Find the required heat transfer area. So this is an automotive radiator which is a cross flow heat exchanger. So reading the problem, you write down the given data. MH equal to mass of the hot air, hot water equal to 0.05 kilograms per second. Hot water temperature is 400 Kelvin, outer temperature 330 Kelvin, air temperature is 300 Kelvin, and mass of the air is 0.75 kilograms per second. Overall heat transfer coefficient 200 watts per meter square Kelvin, and specific heat of the air is taken as 1005 joules per kilogram Kelvin. The specific heat of the water at the mean temperature, which is 92 degrees Celsius, mean temperature of water equal to 92 degrees Celsius. At this temperature, the specific heat of the water from the data book, heat and mass transfer data book, is 4207.6 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And the heat lost by the water, MHCPH into THO minus TCI, which is 0.05 into 4207.6 into 400 minus 330, this is equal to 14,726.6 watts. And outlet temperature of the air, TCO equal to TCI plus Q divided by MC into CPC, substituting the value, this is 319.5 Kelvin. And calculating the LMTD for the counterflow configuration, LMTD equal to 400 minus 319.5 minus 330 minus 300 divided by 80.5 divided by 30, logarithmic of 80.5 divided by 30, which is 51.16 degree Celsius. Now we have to calculate, this is the cross flow heat exchanger, we have to calculate the P and R value. So P value found to be 0.195 and R value found to be 3.6, and from these values we have to take the page number 162, the correction factor is taken from page number 162 for the cross flow heat exchanger with the both fluid unmixed. So the F equal to 0.9. So remember, P and R equations are available in the data book. You have to write the equation and substitute the values, numerical values carefully, and calculate P and R. Then you take the value from the page number 162. Then calculate the heat transfer area. So A equal to Q divided by U into F into LMTD, which is 14,726.6 divided by 200 into 0.92 into 51.16, which is equal to 1.56 meters square. This is what the heat transfer area required for the radiator. So these are the reference books what I have used. You may also refer for any further details. And this is the book what I published earlier. So you may refer for additional problems in the heat exchanger design using the LMTD method. And the mail ID is given here. You can write to me for any clarification or any doubt on the heat exchanger design. So thank you once again. We'll meet.